Sarah, and I'm here with another video, but this time it's not gonna be my friend doing my makeup, it's gonna be me doing my friend makeup. And it's Mother's Day, so I'm gonna try my best, but I'm not a makeup artist. Just want y'all to know that I'm not a makeup artist, so I can't guarantee it's gonna look perfect. But yeah, this is my friend. Y'all see her in the other video, turn it up.
Great.
So yeah,
to start, we are going to be using this Dewy Smooth foundation, Maybelline Fit Me foundation, Dewy Smooth, and the color,
I don't know the color.
Oh, 355 Coconut. This was one of my foundations, but it wasn't like a close enough skin mesh for me. So we're going to use it on her. It's very close to her. It was okay on me though. I like how smooth it was. It was actually really smooth on my skin. Highly recommend.
Are you ready?
I'm scared.
Hey guys, so I'll be doing voiceovers in part of this video because I sped up some parts and I don't want it to get boring. So here I'm just adding the Maybelline Fit Me foundation, Dewy Smooth, in the color 355 Coconut. And I'm blending it out with a foundation brush. I decided to add a little bit more to her cheeks because it looked like it wasn't enough coverage. So that's what I'm doing here. And yeah, basically just adding foundation.
Let's see. And I'm gonna use your eyebrow brush. Head up a little bit. Your eyebrows are pretty full already.
People used to think I got them done.
You look like it.
Here I've decided to use a lightweight brow spoolie since her eyebrows are thick instead of dip brow pomade.
Okay, it looks thick right now, but I'm gonna carve them, okay? So for that, for brows we use, there's no label on here, but this is the Anesthesia Beverly Hills filler brush. So I think it's filler brush. I'll put everything in the description. So this is what it looks like. I think the color is still ebony because I only use the ebony, but yeah, Anesthesia Beverly Hills. We're gonna go in with her concealer, LA Colors Conceal It. The color is CC 567 10. Okay, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right, head up, back carve.
I'm now going in with the concealer to carve her eyebrows on the top and also the bottom. I'm sorry for blocking the camera a little bit, guys. I was really trying to give you guys a good view, but I kept getting so caught up in the makeup that I kept forgetting that I was recording. But yeah, basically just carving out the brows to give it a more sharper look, make it look more clean.
I don't know if they're identical. That one looks thicker. Or am I tripping?
Yeah, just a little bit at the top, but I don't think it's that noticeable.
I'm gonna brush it out and then I'll see if I need to carve one. Oh, this is my
I had noticed that her brows were not symmetrical, so I've decided to go back in and recarve her brows and brush them out to get them as symmetrical as I can. I know a lot of people say like, hey, your brows don't supposed to be twins, they're supposed to be sisters. Well, I need my brows to be as identical as possible. I need them to be twins. Right here, I'm just going in and adding concealer to highlight key points of her face, like her chin, forehead, nose, and under her eyes, to make them just light up and blending. So from here on out, I'll just be blending for a while. So yeah.
I'm gonna go in just a little more though. And I gotta blend with a different brush in the middle of your eyebrows.
I had decided to go in with some dip brow pomade anyway on the tails of her brows, but now rewatching it, I kind of feel like it was a mistake because it kind of changed the shape of her brows overall. Right here, I'm just going in to blend in between her eyebrows and around her eyebrows with a dry beauty blender.
The bottom could look a little white. The highlight purposes is the top. So I'm supposed to.
We've decided to do contour as well. So this is me going in with my contour palette, which is the Fenty Beauty Cream Contour Palette. And I'm just putting it around her face, on forehead, chin, cheekbones, and blending. From here on out, just gonna be a bunch of blending.
Jesus Christ,
I'm gonna
put these just like little dabs on your face, literally.
Now I'm going in with my Tarte concealer. It is a little lighter than her concealer, just to put in like the corner of her eyes and the button of her nose, just to really highlight that area.
So I did highlight, I did contour. I forgot to tell y'all. So for contour, I use the Fenty Cream and Chocolate. I also use the Anesthesia Dip Brow Pomade in the color Ebony. Fenty Beauty Setting Powder in the color Cashew.
I'm applying the Fenty Beauty Setting Powder to the T-zones of her face, so under her eyes, as well as her forehead, or anywhere that I put concealer where I know her face could get oily. Now I'm going in with a fluffy brush and simply wiping away as much powder as I can.
So we're using the same palette as the last video, Neon Bright. And I'm going to pick the color, and she's not going to see the color. But yeah, we're going to do the same.
So for the eyeshadow, I decided to give her a cut crease. So right here, I'm going in with dark because I always put the dark first before I cut the creases. And after I apply the dark, I'm going to go in with another brush and I'm going to try to buff out that color so it doesn't look so harsh. So here I am just adding a little more in spots that look like there is none, and also buffing out in the areas where I feel like it looks harsh.
So now I'm going in with Tarte, whatever, with this little round looking brush for cut creasing.
So now I'm going in to do the cut crease. This is my first time doing a cut crease on someone else. And I've only done a cut crease on myself about 3 times. So it's definitely not going to be a perfect cut crease. And like I said before, I am not a makeup artist. But yeah, I'm going in to do cut creasing. I feel like I made the cut crease too big. I feel like I could have made it a little smaller, but it is what it is. So here I'm basically going to be fanning her face, trying to get the concealer to dry a little faster before I start applying the base eyeshadow. You can see here what I was talking about when I said that I made the cut crease too big. I know next time to make it a bit smaller.
The color we're going to use was going to be that color, but it looks too pink. So we're going to use this color. Are you ready? Okay. Yellow, here we go.
This part is kind of self-explanatory. I'm just applying the yellow over the cut crease concealer. I'm not really rubbing it onto the concealer. I'm more patting it on so that it could be more vibrant, because this palette is from 5 and below. If it was a Morphe palette, then it wouldn't take as much, but it's not. And yeah, I'm basically just patting on the eyeshadow from here on out. And then towards the end of this clip, you'll see me buffering out the two colors together. Right here, it wasn't quite vibrant enough for me, so I got like a more flat, firmer brush, I can say, and I just applied a little more over what I've already applied.
I like it.
You don't want none on your bottom, right?
Mm-mm, what you talking about?
When people be having eyeshadow down
there. Hell no. To the na-na.
We have Fenty Beauty Highlighter. It is the kilowatt highlighter. We have lightning dust and fire crystal, and we're going to be using the lightning dust color.
Now I'm applying the highlighter on the high points of her cheekbones, the bridge and the button of her nose, and I'm also going to apply a little bit under her eyebrows. Here, I also decided to put it in the corner of her eyes.
That's basically the look, guys. Basically, oh wait, I gotta fix it. Go back. You saw that?
What?
Other side. Mm. Fuck, I'm finna fix it. So I'm finna fix that, y'all, with her concealer, because it's closer to her skin color. And I'm going to just go on the sides to fix it. Get it fixed. Tie your head. Get it fixed. Lip gloss is called Smoked and Mirrors Honey Infused Lip Oil.
5 below once again.
5 and below, y'all.
Came in like a 5 or 4 pack.
Period. This pencil right here, I got from my local beauty supply. I don't know the color because it came off, but yeah.
Once again, this is a part that's also self-explanatory. All I'm doing is outlining her lips with a pencil. And then I'm going to go in with her lip gloss and use lip gloss on her lips. You can tell that she wasn't really feeling the liner because it was her first time, so I was trying to clean up the edges to give her a better feel of it. I actually liked it. I think she ended up okay with it.
You guys can follow me on Instagram @essenceactiveson.com. essenceactiveson. Simple as that.
I'm gonna make sure to put her Instagram down in the description. Also gotta add it to the other video too. I forgot.
So I decided to add more gloss to her lips just to make them more glossy.
Get them. Hey. 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 Oh.
So once again, very self-explanatory. I'm just putting on eyelashes now.
How do you feel about Essence?
I like it.
You like it?
Mm-hmm.
If you had to rate it, what would you rate it?
Honey.
Make sure you comment down below how you think I did on this look. And And yeah, see y'all in another video.